Hi, how are you going? I hope you're feeling as well as possible on your medicines. I'm Pharmacist Fi, and this is Denver. Welcome to our Medicine Safety YouTube channel and to this episode of How Does That Work? Where we'll take a sneak peek at the fascinating way a medicine called Colchicine works for people with gout. And you may know Colchicine by brand names like Colgout or Lengout in Australia, or Colcrys, Mitigare, or Gloperba in the USA. You probably already know that our body is mostly made up of cells, which are very small, and there are lots of different types of cells, and even our blood has a lot of types of cells in it. And you may also have heard that some of the immune system cells that move around our body in our blood are like commando warriors roaming through our body to fight things like bacteria or viruses or fungi. And one of the main types of these little immune cells that fight bacteria are called neutrophils. Right now, I bet you're wondering what the immune system cells have to do with gout, because gout's not an infection. Well, a gout attack happens if we have too much uric acid in our blood and if some of this uric acid solidifies into urate crystals on the outer parts of one or more of our joints. Our neutrophil cells think that the urate crystals are an invading enemy. But if a modern, relatively low dose of colchicine is taken for gout, it mostly gets absorbed into immune cells, including neutrophils. And what colchicine does is to reduce the neutrophil's ability to make things called microtubules, which are tiny, ever-changing 3D lattice networks throughout the neutrophil that help the neutrophil to move through our body and to release chemical signals to attract other immune cells. And neutrophils might also release reactive oxygen species, some of which are free radicals, which you might have heard of. And these things are designed to damage bacteria by chemically reacting with them. But unfortunately, they can sometimes cause a bit of friendly fire for our own cells. For example, if neutrophils decide to release these tiny reactive oxygen species at the urate crystals on our joints when there are no bacteria in sight. So reducing these activities by our own immune cells is how colchicine is believed to reduce and also prevent the inflammation of gout flares. Whereas urate-lowering medicines, for example allopurinol, help to reduce the amount of uric acid in our body and the crystals in the gout-affected joints. This all sounds pretty amazing and helpful. So why do people taking colchicine for gout need to be so careful to remember to tell the doctor if you have any kidney or liver problems, and also tell the doctor absolutely everything you are currently taking and have taken in the past 2 weeks? Some medicines interact with colchicine in a way which could increase the level of colchicine in our body and cause toxicity. Also, colchicine is removed from our body by our kidneys and liver. So if they're not functioning fast enough, and if the doctor does not give an extra low dose schedule to make up for this, then colchicine may reach too high a level in our body, which could cause toxicity. Toxicity would mean that instead of just reducing how active the neutrophil cells are, our ability to make microtubules in a lot of other types of cells could be affected too, which would reduce our ability to make new cells, which is very important for staying alive. Thankfully, colchicine toxicity is rare these days, now that a lot of doctors are prescribing modern low-dose schedules for gout and minimizing medicine interactions, plus giving even lower doses for people with significant kidney or liver problems. If you don't already have one, make sure you get a CMI, which is Consumer Medicine Information, about your brand of colchicine from your doctor or pharmacist, and read the sections about what the side effect symptoms of colchicine toxicity are and what to do about them if they happen. And also the section about medicines which may interact with colchicine. And please also watch my colchicine part 1 and part 2 videos in my Some Need to Know Info playlist for some very important things to talk about with your doctor, including ways to minimize side effects and medicine interactions with colchicine. Please click the subscribe and like buttons below this video if you'd like to see more of these medicine safety videos. And Denver and I look forward to catching up with you again very soon here on this Pharmacist Fi Medicine Safety YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.